Hello, Windows Universe. In this video, we will look at what you can do if you receive the message your organization has set some policies to manage updates. As always, there will be an informative article linked in the description down below if you need more information on the subject. Now, two things. These fixes are mostly aimed at systems that there is only one user on the PC, or if you are the admin in the account. If you are not the admin, then it is probably a given that you should contact your system admin for more information, and that you create a system restore point before making any of these changes to your system. 1. A good first measure is to try system restore. If this is a recent problem, then restoring your computer to a point before you had the problem might be a safe bet. To do that, type restore in the System Properties dialog box, go to System Protection, System Restore, and follow the on-screen prompts. If you are on a computer that is Pro or higher, then you have access to something called the Root Policy Editor. In that case, go to Computer Configuration, Administrative Templates, Windows Components, Windows Updates. Look for the following policies and change the settings to not configured. Intranet Update Service for detecting updates. Allow connecting to Windows Update Internet locations. Disable all online services for Windows updates except managed services. Use alternate URL for update services. Configure an alternate location for downloading updates when scanning against a managed service. Do not connect to any Windows Update Internet locations. Notify to download updates and set automatic update options. As I said, set those to not configured. Then restart your computer and see if the problem's corrected. If this happened after you signed up for the Windows Insider program, then you should consider opting out. To do this, open Settings, go to Update and Security, and Windows Insider program. Toggle the switch for stop getting preview builds or stop getting insiders to the off position. Restart your system and see if this fixes the problem. You can try and re-enable Windows updates. In the article, we talk about update tools that you can download to try and enable it. If nothing else works, you can try to reset your PC. There are two options. You can use the cloud download option, and the article we link goes step by step on how to do this, or you can type reset, go to Get Started, and follow the on-screen prompts. For more useful tips on how to maximize your Windows experience, go to our website, thewindowsclub.com. Do not forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel, where we are always adding new content aimed at making your digital world just a little bit easier. Thanks for watching and have a nice day.